Catalog there and see what we have. Hello everyone, welcome once again to Scorpion Cigar Reviews. My friend Larry here once again.
Hello.
We'll be smoking I've never heard of this one before, a Mayorga Nicaragua CA. This is a box pressed cigar. And it's actually tapered a little bit above the shoulder. Got a pretty good, pretty squared off box press. It's kind of soft pack, very spongy.
excuse me. Not listed.
Okay. Good looking wrapper though, and it feels nice. Nice and smooth, very.
There's a compact.
Yeah, very
press.
Very hard box press. But the wrapper feels really nice, very smooth. It has almost a, I would call it chewy on that pack. It feels like it would be chewy, like a gummy worm or something, real chewy like that. It actually has a soft spot about halfway through it. Now, cigars like this make me wonder if the reason why they box pressed it was when they rolled the cigar, said, oh, we didn't put enough tobacco in there. It's too loosely packed. So they try to make up for that by box pressing it and forcing everything together. That's just my theory. I don't know that for a fact. But, you know, there are some cigars where they intend to box press them. And then I'd be willing to bet that there are cigars that they said, uh-oh.
I think I would put this in that category.
Where they box pressed it to try to correct
yeah.
an improper pack.
I could be mistaken.
Right, and that's my feeling on it.
I mean, the wrapper looks like it's put on pretty well.
Yeah. Yeah, I've seen cigars where they box pressed them and you see where the wrapper has then crinkled and overlapped and bunched from the box pressing, and to me something like that is pretty obvious that they box pressed it to try to firm up the pack.
Right.
But you know, I could be wrong. I don't. That's not necessarily always the case.
You think that's the old 10 pounds in a 5 pound.
About five
box
pounds in a 10 pound bag. Yeah.
Well, we'll find out shortly. I'm gonna cut.
Once again, not a whole lot. Scent on the wrapper.
Very.
Yeah, not much anything there at all. The foot. Even the foot is very.
Nothing there stands out other than the
right,
tobacco itself.
Okay, I'm getting a little bit coming through now. Grains.
I did.
Okay, I didn't see you cut it. Now, I did a video once where I went through the whole process of, you know, probing the cigar and smelling it and everything else.
Well,
you know,
and
I start lighting. I said, God, I can't get this darn thing to light unless I didn't cut the son of a bitch.
That'll do it.
Yep, we do it every time. If you don't cut it, you won't get a draw.
Wouldn't think it's very pricey.
And this was from JR's?
This is from JR Tobacco.
From JR's. Okay, got this through JR's. When'd you get this? A week ago? A
week ago. So okay, so we'll get the 20th.
Okay, about the 20th. Okay. And today is 9/28. We'll call it. By the time we get started, we'll call it. Well, you've already started. Call it 1805. Good enough.
Pretty strong head on. Hmm?
That bitterness is gone now. This may be a cigar that I'll have to purge right off the bat. It may not have been completely fermented. So there may be some impurities that will burn off.
The wrapper look is not bad at all.
No, and it feels great. It's a very, very nice feeling wrapper. It's very smooth, soft, nice feel to the leaf. Good amount of moisture to it. Sometimes they'll be almost dried up, but this one feels like it's very pliable yet.
Cigar weight, I'm sure it's proportion for its size. It's probably on the light side, I would say.
Yeah, not too far off, though. Definitely bitter, even with the purge. Good-looking wrapper. It's nice, even, like a coffee-colored. Very minimal veins. Nice tight seams.
There are very few veins. Sure.
Yeah, and the ones that are there, they're very small.
I don't see one on mine, any on mine.
In fact, I see more wrinkled from the box pressing than I do veins. Almost no vein. Heavily box pressed.